McClure described how Bobbert gave her his last $20 when she ran out of gas. This is Johnny, McClure's GoFundMe post starts, with a photo of Bobbert and McClure. She works for the New Jersey Department of Transportation. Driving into Philly one night, I made the mistake of thinking that I would be able to make it all the way down I-95 with my gas light on, McClure wrote. Needless to say, I was wrong. I never ran out of gas before, and my heart was beating out of my chest. I pulled over as far as I could, and got out of the car to head to the nearest gas station. Luckily, she ran across Johnny, a total stranger, who was homeless. That's when I met Johnny. Johnny sits on the side of the road every day, holding a sign, she wrote. He saw me pull over and knew something was wrong. He told me to get back in the car and lock the doors. A few minutes later, he comes back with a red gas can, using his last $20 to make sure I could get home safe. Johnny did not ask me for a dollar, and I couldn't repay him at that moment because I didn't have any cash. But I have been stopping by his spot for the past few weeks. One woman who knows Johnny's family wrote on the GoFundMe page, Kate, Johnny is the son of a family I have known since childhood. The last I knew, he was a paramedic in my area of NC, and a very good one. I am so grateful that God put you in his path and I will be offering my prayers in this situation, in hopes full restoration of Johnny's future. I am truly grateful for the angels that walk among us. Another friend wrote, Johnny has always had a helping heart. As an old friend and former co-worker, I was so shocked and saddened to hear that he was homeless. Thanks for helping him. He truly deserves it. Moved by Johnny's selflessness, McClure began helping the stranger and researching his life. As McClure recounts on GoFundMe, she couldn't get the homeless man's kindness out of her mind. I repaid him for the gas, gave him a jacket, gloves, a hat, and warm socks, and I give him a few dollars every time I see him, she wrote. I wish that I could do more for this selfless man, who went out of his way just to help me that day. He is such a great guy, and talking to him each time I see him makes me want to help him more and more. She continued trying to help him. One day I stopped to see him and had a few things in a bag to give him, one of which was a box of cereal bars so he could have something that he could carry around and eat. He was very appreciative as usual and the first thing he said was, "Do you want one?" Another time I dropped off two Wawa gift cards and a case of water. The first words that came out of his mouth were, "I can't wait to show the guys, there are two others he hangs out with and they all take care of each other." If just those two statements alone do not give you a glimpse of the good heart this man has, I'm not sure anything will. But the story doesn't end there. Johnny Bobbert once served in the U.S. Marine Corps and was a paramedic, reports say. McClure described on GoFundMe how she researched Bobbert's life and discovered he had once served in the U.S. Marine Corps as well as working as a paramedic and firefighter. We found Johnny's Facebook page, and I just wanted to share some photos with you guys to give you a glimpse into his life before this happened, she wrote. You can see the photos she shared earlier in this story and above. Johnny is a veteran of the U.S. Marine Corps, and was a firefighter, paramedic. This is just a reminder that this could happen to any of us. Thank you all again so much for sharing and donating, McClure wrote. Heavy has reached